Do you have a philosophy of life, Mr. Getty? Do you ever wonder, for instance, why you should be very rich and somebody else very poor?
I have wondered sometimes about that. Wondered why some people who apparently have very good ability, work hard, and still never seem to make success of anything they do, and other people apparently less brilliant somehow seem to make success. Must be some factors there that are not too well recognized. Probably a sense of timing and a sense of proportion probably has something to do with it. Some people who are very brilliant, never able to distinguish the possible from the impossible. That's one thing. If a man is going to make success, he has to start with something that's possible for him to do. If he has an impossible objective, well, then he's not going to be successful.
Mm-hmm. And yet, in the case of both yourself and your father, you tackled the impossible. You drilled oil wells where other people thought there was no oil?
No, it wasn't impossible. It was difficult. It was,
I see.
It's different trying to do the difficult and trying to do the impossible.
You don't agree with the man who said the impossible takes a little longer.
Yes.
Do you,
I think the impossible can't be done.
I see. Do you ever worry about the biblical proverb about the rich man in the kingdom of heaven?
Yes, I do. I think that rich man should bear that in mind.
Are you a religious person?
I'm a Methodist, and I believe in religion.
But you haven't worried about the proverb of the rich man enough to begin dispersing the Getty fortune.
Well, there's some other things about in the Bible too that indicate that the man who looks after his vineyard is worthy of some praise.